Do you really need to write a cover letter? And if so, how do you write one that stands out to recruiters that are scanning hundreds of applications at a time? In this video, I'll explain what an employer really wants from a cover letter, the ideal cover letter format, and three key strategies to boost your cover letter's impact and quality. Be sure to stick around for the last one because it's an insider look on how to amplify your cover letter so that it ends up in the hands of people that can make a real difference in your job search. All right, let's get into it. What do employers really want from a cover letter? Well, let's start with your resume. Your resume provides a ton of great information about you, but at the end of the day, it's just an outline of your professional history. Sometimes though, employers and recruiters want you to connect the dots for them, explaining not just your professional history, but why you are the best, most qualified candidate for the role. So therefore, a great cover letter serves both as a professional introduction of sorts and a sales pitch, leaving the recruiter intrigued to learn more about you. Now, in terms of when to submit a cover letter, I think we all know don't submit one if an employer does not ask for one or says no cover letters. We all know it's probably important to submit one if it says cover letter required or you're directly asked for one. However, it can be kind of tricky navigating the cover letter optional statement. So here's a few quick things to navigate or think about when you are deciding whether or not you should go through the effort of writing a cover letter. The first thing to know is that most, though not all, cover letters do go unread. So obviously that's something to consider. It's a lot of time and effort for something that may not help you actually get in the door. That being said, even when it comes to first rounds of interviews, the second interviewing enters the equation, a lot of people find that having written a cover letter is really beneficial for their performance in an interview. That's because you're having to consciously think about what's my angle in terms of how I'm presenting my professional history and why am I best suited for the job. So keep that in mind. It may not get you in the door, but it may help boost your performance once you're there. The second thing to know is that submitting a cover letter is often considered an extra step of commitment and interest to the role. So that means a lot of people will default to cover letter optional. Oh, I should write a cover letter in every single case. Where this rule falls apart is that although it does show commitment, it's never smart to submit a cover letter that you haven't been able to give your full attention. So maybe you didn't have time to think about, you know, how am I strategically angling myself for this role? Maybe you didn't have time to proofread, or maybe it's just a generic cover letter that's not tailored to the job application in particular at all. In that case, it's far better to submit no cover letter and let your resume speak for itself rather than maybe hindering your application by submitting a cover letter that's less than representative of your professional standard. And the last thing to know is that if you are making some kind of change in your career, be it re-entering the workforce after time off, you're changing industries, you're looking for maybe a more senior job title than you have had in the past, cover letters are a great opportunity to supplement your resume and give additional context to those kinds of changes. Look at it as an opportunity to tell your professional story. So if you're someone that's making that kind of change, keep in mind that a cover letter is a really useful thing to provide. All right, and finally, I'm gonna be moving on to the ideal cover letter format. But before I do, if you've watched this far, please give us a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit the notification bell so that you stay updated on this important career advice. Here's the optimal format for writing a cover letter. Step one is to start with your header. This should include your name, contact information, and the employer's contact information. And pro tip here, whatever you do in terms of formatting and font styling, so font size, the font you select, etc., try and keep it consistent with what's on your resume so that your application as a whole looks thoughtful and cohesive. Then include a greeting. It's best to be specific here if possible. So do your best to do some research if it's not obvious based on the job application and try and find the exact name of the person that will be reviewing applications for this role. If you can't find their exact preferred title, whether it's Mr. or Mrs. or some other title, just say, dear first and last name. And if you can't find who the hiring manager is at all, just go with dear hiring manager. It's best to stay away from overly formal language. So that would be to whom it may concern or to whom it may concern a company X. That's just because it feels a little dated. So better stick with those options instead. So then you can write a first paragraph. And the goal here is to grab attention from that first line and explain why you're interested in this particular role and company. And you also want to explain the key experience or qualifications that you believe make you the best fit. Now, there are two critical tips for nailing this section. Tip one here is to grab your reader from the very start. Instead of having this more generic, self-focused opening, try really boldly stating a selling point, something that's different, unique to you, and will set you apart from a ton of the other applications that they're reading. So an example would be, instead of saying something generic, like I'm a detail-oriented people person who's capable of problem solving with out-of-the-box solutions, try something that boldly states that biggest professional offering. So I've got three quick examples if you're curious. The first would be, in my last position as an English teacher, I inspired hundreds of students to love reading. How can I spread that love of reading and learning throughout your school? Or, sales increased over 30% when I took over the print media department at my marketing company. What would 30% do for your sales goals? And finally, I've hired, onboarded, and trained a dozen customer service representatives in the last 6 months. I can turn individual contributors into a team of rock stars. The second tip here on nailing that first paragraph is to express your motivation and explain why this company should hire you. Be explicit about that key offering and why you're so excited to get the job. For example, you could say something like, every time I see your products at the grocery store, I pass by all the generic versions and grab that one. I'm already a loyal fan and would love to bring my enthusiasm to this team. Now, if there are personal experiences not highlighted in your resume that are applicable here, go ahead and mention them, again, highlighting that as a part of your key motivation. So, for example, if you lived in another country and this job requires international exposure, go ahead and briefly foreshadow that personal nugget. Next up, follow with a second paragraph. And the goal here is to highlight the key achievements, skills, and specialties that make you very well suited for this particular position. Now, don't fall into the big trap of this section, and it's applicable to cover letters in general, but most people kind of fall into that in this second paragraph, which is, do not simply restate or narrate your resume. What's the point? It doesn't add anything. You're just wasting space. The goal is to add more professional color here and make a strong case for yourself. So instead of narrating your resume, I really encourage you to focus on two or three key professional accomplishments or experiences that directly tie back to that job description and speak to the role, and that really impacted the bent and shape of your career. Finally, finish it out with a closing paragraph. If you're changing careers, this is a great opportunity to explain how your former experience really well equips you for this new opportunity, as well as why you're making that change. But regardless of your circumstances, briefly, that's the key word here, briefly summarize why you're interested in the role and why you're extremely qualified for it and think you'd be the best fit, as well as finally making a last call to action for the employer, sharing that you're looking forward to hearing next steps in the job process from them, and then make sure to include your signature at the bottom. If you'd like to learn how to create a standout resume to accompany your now amazing cover letter, then I highly recommend this video right here. We explain the key steps to writing a winning resume. Now that we know what to include in a cover letter, I'll quickly breeze through three really impactful strategies on how to make your cover letter an incredibly successful one. So the first strategy is to tailor your cover letter to each job application. Now, this is generally true for resumes as well, but it's especially important for cover letters because it's all about making a case, making your argument. And if you don't have a specific audience in mind that you're speaking to, you're just sending a general cover letter out, you're not making a very good argument. It's really important to go ahead and make sure that you are thinking critically about how you're going to frame your past experience to most convince this particular employer as to why you'd be a great fit for this role. If you don't, you're just sort of talking about your past experience without connecting the dots to this role in particular and explaining how that past experience sets you up for success in the future. Now, of course, doing this successfully requires a lot of research, both in terms of the job itself and the company. And my next tip here actually is a really great example of how to implement that research in the cover letter itself. Strategy two is to transcribe exact phrases from the job description and put those, reference them in quotes in your cover letter. Now, this cannot be the sum total of the way that you tailor your cover letter. It can't just be a plug and play game because you've got to actually think about the overall structure and argument you're making as well. But by doing this, you're making it really clear to the recruiter that you're targeting this job specifically, and it allows you to speak more directly to the exact wants and needs of this particular job application. So, for example, if the job ad says, must be collaborative and work seamlessly with a distributed workforce, pull that out by saying, in my current role, I work with a large team of colleagues across time zones, so I understand what it takes to succeed in this role since it requires experience with a distributed workforce, referring to that phrase from the job description. Finally, to really get noticed, strategically share your cover letter. And what I mean by that is, don't just stop at attaching this cover letter to your job application. Instead, think strategically and use all that great research that you've done to identify one or two individuals who you can reasonably assume will have an impact on the hiring decision here, and using the cover letter as the basis for your email or note, message them directly. For example, in terms of finding someone, if you are applying for an HR coordinator position, it is very reasonable to assume that the head of HR may need to sign off on that decision or may have some pretty big sway in making that decision. So, in order to find their contact information, you can look at the company's professional website, their professional social media profile, or even just a broad internet search using their name to see if you can uncover their email. And if your cover letter is short and informal enough to have that be the entire email, great, go ahead and use that. Or if it's more lengthy and a bit more formal, not appropriate for an email, try and cut it down. Then finally, end with a call to action. Something like, I look forward to discussing further the assets that I can bring to your team. Please reach out to me and give them your phone number and your email address. This can be kind of a nerve-wracking strategy because it does put yourself out there a bit, but especially when you weigh out the fact that they have a ton of applicants and probably some applicants that have personal connections, this can be a really great way of pulling your application out of the stack and allowing yourself to rise above those who didn't show that same initiative. If you liked this video and found it helpful, please give us a like down below, subscribe to our channel right here. For more interviewing advice, as well as cover letter and resume advice, check it out right here. And if you want some information on the most common mistakes that people make writing their resume, highly recommend checking out this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.